already huge match up against somebody in the lobby, it will show you who the opponent is, their name, their rank, and their character. And like I said in that video, if that was the only advantage that the software gave you, it's already huge enough of an advantage that it invalidates any kind of progress you make as a Tekken player. It completely invalidates your rank and everything else, right? But then other things you can do is, for example, say, next time I win a match, I would like to get the rank.
Round one. Fight.
Yeah.
KO. Round two. Fight. Round three, fight.
God Prime or TGO, and if you win a single match, you will promote you to that place. And then we talked about things like the one hit kill hack, which is a hack that makes it so that when you hit an opponent with a single poke in the first round, you instantly win all three rounds, and it registers as a win on your side. And then you can use a forced desync to escape that match and run away with your artificial win. But if you were the victim of a player like that, it's likely that you would sort of understand that something was going on if there was a desync after a single hit in the first round.
Round one. Fight.
Yeah.
and so on. But it turns out that Tekken cheating has since then evolved in some pretty serious ways, and it's become really quite subtle. And I think it might be the fact that you are constantly, when you're playing online right now, playing against many, many people who are cheating in all kinds of ways, and you might not realize it because of how subtle and sophisticated it's gone. And I started thinking about this a while ago when Little Margin made a video about this, where he talked about how not only are people running scripts and doing all these things, there's a lot of disinformation and counterattacking that happens all of a sudden. Not counterattacking in the game, we'll get to that as well, but sort of in the social media space, because you have so many people that they don't want it to be common knowledge, they don't want it to be understood well, but it's also true that people access and create this software, they're selling it for money, and so they stand to gain financially from this information being suppressed, and from all of this being poorly understood, right? And that's why you have to be very careful when you talk about this sort of thing. Now, then something really interesting happened 2 days ago. I woke up and I looked at my Discord, which I have now with hundreds of members who are talking about the game and posting memes and stuff. It's really amazing and enjoyable. But a person contacted me privately on Discord, and for the purposes of this video, we're going to call him Mike. And Mike told me that something had happened with him when he was playing Tekken. He was playing with a group of people online.
Round one. Fight. Fight.